And he said, Eunice. That's what he called me. Don't ask me why, but he said, whenever I think of you as Eunice, it makes me laugh. So it was okay. And he said, I'll be there. You can count on me. And that was the truth. All his friends, and there were so many, could always count on Rock Hudson. Not only was he a very talented dramatic actor, as we all know, his favorite thing was comedy. And he always said to me, the best time I've ever had was making comedies with you. And I really felt the same way. We had a ball. As I reflect on his arrival in Carmel, I can only tell you, my friends, that it was a heartbreaking time for me to see him. He didn't talk about his illness, not one time. He just said, Eunice, I've had the flu, and I can't gain weight. And I said, you've come to the right place, my darling, because I'm going to put weight on you. I'm going to force feed you. And we laughed. And he said, I just can't gain, and I have no appetite. And of course, I felt that he wasn't feeling well enough to work. And I told him, I said, you know, nothing is as important as your health. You don't have to do this show, and I don't want you to. I want you to forget it. I want you to just stay in Carmel for a while and relax and enjoy it. And he said, forget it. I came here to do your show. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. And he did. That's what he did. And he was wonderful. And I feel that without my deep faith, I would be a lot sadder than I am today. I know that life is eternal and that something good is going to come from this experience. On the second half of this show, I'm going to be sharing with you the film that turned out to be our last visit together. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was beautiful.
I really enjoyed doing that too, because those people are not only incredible, but they're amazing.
Steve, it was so thrilling to me to see the relationships between those people mm-hmm. and the animals. Oh, that was just, it should be that way in all the convalescent homes, in all the hospitals. They should have
right.
animals to love and to hold and to pet and to kiss and to talk to.
Well, you know, what's an interesting facet about that particular feature is that the adults, or the lambs, which they call themselves, the retarded folks, that they not only rejected from society, but if you can believe this, even from some of their families.
Animals love you. Mm-hmm. Without conditions. It isn't, you give me something to eat, I'll love you. Or you pet me and I'll love you.
Yeah.
They love you anyway. And that's why they're so wonderful mm-hmm. with those people.
Beautiful.
And the people have something to care about. It's just yeah. wonderful.
They have a purpose, right?
Yes. Yeah. Thank you for bringing that feature.
Oh, my pleasure.
It was thrilling.
Thank you. Back again.
Yeah, and you made me cry. You always make me cry, Steve. Bless the beast and the children.
The children. A little friend of mine from the Monterey SPCA named Martin. This little guy is a terrific little guy, and he's going to make a wonderful pet for a very lucky family. And you have to be very careful in choosing a pet for your family. One of the important things is the size of your yard. You see, Martin right now, and he's crying, is a little guy, but he's going to grow into a very big guy. So he's going to need a lot of yard space to run and exercise. So now Dr. Tom Kendall is going to answer a lot of questions for you to consider before choosing a pet for your family. Dr. Tom.
Hello?
I love my roses.
Well, hiya.
They are gorgeous.
I'm glad. Pretty roses for a pretty blonde.
Thank you. That's so sweet of you.
Thank you.
And you know what?
What?
I am thrilled that you are going to do my show.
I am too.
You're my first guest.
Is that right?
Very first one, because you're a very special
guest. Well, I am delighted about that. Therefore, I shall take the first flight up next Monday.
Neat. I can't wait to... What?
I'll take the first flight up next Monday.
Oh, Rock. Hey, you know what? There's a slight problem.
What?
Well, we're on kind of a tight budget, you know, on this new show.
Yeah.
And if you don't mind, I mean, could you take the bus?
The bus?
Suppose you'd like a cookie now. Here.
There you are. Did my biggest get tired?
No, I did.
Oh, you... I walked you around pretty good.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's so good to see you.
Oh, it's good.
I miss those laughs we used to have.
Oh, me too.
I do. We had so much fun.
I haven't had a good laugh like that since.
We really had fun making movies.
Yeah.
Didn't we?
Yeah. I wish we'd made more.
We should do it again.
Yeah, we should. What was your favorite movie? will you?
What was my favorite?
Mm-hmm.
I think I like Pillow Talk.
Pillow Talk?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Did you?
No, I liked Ice Station Zebra.
You rat! I am so full.
I am too. I couldn't eat another bite.
That was so good.
Delicious.
Great cook.
Delicious. Thank you. You
and,
too.
Oh, you know, you were so good on the show.
As
really
are you a good
thanks.
Hostess.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Want to see a movie tonight?
Oh, I'd love to. Love to see a movie. Okay. I have to catch my bus.
Bus?
Francisco, and we were doing a concert. I had all the guys that used to be in the band when you were flown up to San Francisco. We had a reunion. Now we're heading back to L.A. We decided to come down the scenic route on Route 1. Butch says, hey, that's Carmel. That's where Doris is.
I said that.
He said that.
You couldn't get to the reunion, so we're going to come to you.
So I am so thrilled. That is sensational. That is so, where did you get the bus?
That's something.
That is really cute.
Well, I don't know if the guys think so, but that bus was built in the year I started with the band out of Duke University, 1936. So
you're
for
kidding.
The reunion, we hired
it's
that.
An antique. Yeah. It's so cute.
It's
now, look. Hey, now, look. You're not working anywhere tonight.
We are tonight only.
Then you're going to stay.
Well,
you're going to stay here overnight. You are? I don't want to hear any baloney from anybody. I have plenty of bedrooms, yeah. Really. And Mrs. Rail, my cook, is fabulous. Oh. We'll have a great dinner. You're going to stay.
What do you think, Chloe?
Sounds good.
Oh, I'm thrilled. I'm so glad to
I get
see
one of the
you.
Dogs.
Do we still get to see him? That's all I want to know.
Do we still get to see him? I
got
one of the dogs
to sleep
with me.
Oh, okay. That's
yeah, the dogs. Sleep with the dogs. Okay?
I want to see all the dogs.
Okay, sure. We'll stay.
Oh, I'm overwhelmed. My heart is pounding.
Well, the rest of them get here. You know how many there are.
We have a 50-piece band now.
I can take care of it. Come on in.
Okay. How about
bring your stuff.
Bring all your
stuff in. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I miss everybody.
Well, about those flies, you know, what's happening about it?
Mrs. Rail puts on a good dinner. She doesn't know that she's a house.
I think that's
like a bad one for me. We have a B on the table. Mr. B. Albrown. Think he is a handsome fellow. Fat and fuzzy, brown and fuzzy. Busy, Mr. B.
You're a strong guy. Give him a
that was the first piece. Wait a minute now. Hold it now. Hold it. I'm quiet. Who wants third?
Oh, jeez. No, thank you.
I have one. Mr. Shanahan. Mr. Shanahan wins third. Let's hear it for Mrs. Rail, the cook. Yay, Mrs. Rail. Mrs. Rail. Yeah, all right.
Time, but we haven't all been together.
I know.
You remember the Cafe Rouge.
I loved the Cafe Rouge.
That was
my favorite
gig.
Place.
That was the only good gig.
Yeah.
Not the Palladium.
Right. When we played there, we were there, what, a month? Six weeks?
Six weeks.
Then my mother and my son, Terry, would come. Nana would cook.
Right in the room.
And chase Terry. And you would babysit Terry.
Yeah, and chase him.
Yeah, and chase him. Down the halls.
Down the halls, upstairs.
That was my favorite place. I loved it.
Hey, I would like to be serious for one moment.
All right.
I haven't seen you since the 40s, and it's something's been on my mind, and I finally get a chance to see you. I would like to know who's going to reimburse me for a fine that I played for dropping you off at the Hollywood Plaza one night in Hollywood. You had a date with Jack Carson, if you remember.
Get a lot of pictures. Mm.
Yeah. I had a few.
And I double parked.
How do you know about that?
Well, because you told me. You had to get there, and I double parked to let you out of the car, and a cop pulled me.
What were
me.
You doing there?
Driving you home to the Hollywood Plaza.
He was short for you.
My wife and I, we took you home.
Really?
Yes.
He was practicing driving.
I don't remember that either.
I remember. The reason I remember is I got a ticket for it. And it cost me $15 for double parking, and I would like to know who's going to reimburse me for that.
I didn't pay you for that?
No. And I hate to bring it up.
Zounds.
But
do you know what? Your room tonight is a little more than
oh,
that.
Yes, yeah. It's a nice place. Well,
so,
if you saw my room, I don't think you'd think it was worth more than that. But we'll call it even, Dallas. We'll call it even. Okay, I just had to get out.
We're
my
even.
Chest.
Yeah. I don't want to hear about it anymore.
Know, until the next time we do a show with you,
though. Dallas, right. I think it's time we got serious. I'd like to turn it over to Doris and ask her all about this Pet Foundation. We just got here, and we're not sure what it's all about. And I think the guys would like to know. Maybe they'll all come out with a couple of
questions. Well, you know, when you arrived, you heard all the barking. You know that I have a lot of dogs.
Yeah. We've heard about that.
I have a lot of cats. I do have a Pet Foundation. And before you leave, you're all going to be members. I just thought I'd drop that in. Yeah.
The gate is locked.
Don't be giving me the addresses.
I put up with you guys for so many years. You owe it to me.
Right.
What is it going to cost to become a member?
You'll find out in the mail.
20!
Do I owe you five?
No, you asked me about the Pet Foundation.
Yeah.
Anyway, the reason that I got started in it, and I have to be serious for a moment, is that, you know, there are a lot of needy people. I know that, and there are a lot of worthy causes. But as far as animal welfare, I felt that this area was really neglected. And I felt that I had to be a part of that. And that's why I got involved. And then when I, you know, read statistics on how many animals are put down every week in this country, it's just astounding. So we're going to do something about it if we can. It's a small scale now, but it's going to be better and bigger. And we've been treating the effect in taking animals in to a kennel and boarding them and trying to find homes for all the strays. That is just the effect. The cause is spaying and neutering. And that's what we're going to do, and have free clinics, if we can, all over the country, to spay and neuter the animals and cut down on the population. Let's hear it from me. I thank you. Yeah.
Can I see you outside?
Yeah, I'm expecting.
I want to ask Charlie something.
Well, yes, by
the way. This
what
is this?
Just come with me. This has to be
what do you think
private.
This is about?
Talk to each other, fellas.
Remember, yeah.
Watch his old.
Do you think I can trust him in the bushes out there?
Yeah. He's old.
Excuse me, and then we're going to have dessert. Okay. Okay. See you in a minute.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
All right. The reason I got you out here, I wanted to ask you in private, what do you think about singing with the band again?
Singing with the band again?
Why not?
There's no room on that bus.
I tell you, you can sit in my lap.
Oh, no, I knew you'd say
no,
that.
But to be serious, what I meant, not sing with the band on a regular basis, just I think we should get together again, have a reunion, you and I and the whole band, and do something for the Pet Foundation. We can raise a little money. Believe me, start thinking about it. The people would love to see us back together again. And I want you to promise, yeah, for the Pet Foundation. Because when you were talking about it, I got the idea. So what do you think? Will you promise to think about it?
I'll think about that. Where's the music coming from?
What music? Why don't I show you? Come with me.
Each time I could afford
to hear that all aboard.
Great time. Thanks so much.
I hate to see you go. I hate to see you go.
Great to see you. Well, keep
the look. Oh, I love him. I'm sure everybody knows. It's so good to see you.
Thanks for the food.
Oh.
Thanks for the bed.
I almost...
Think over what I talked to you about last night.
I will.
Bye, dear.
Bye.
Bye.
Take care of yourself. Got that in. Take care now. You got everybody? Okay, bye. Let me hear from you. Oh!
Gonna take a sentimental journey. Gonna set my heart at ease, gonna make a sentimental journey to renew old memories. Got my bag, got my reservation, spent each dime I could afford, like a child wild anticipation, long to hear that all aboard. Never thought my heart could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? Gotta take that sentimental journey.
Excuse me, is that your dog?
No, he's just been following me.
Oh. Robbie! Come on in. Lunch is ready.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
It's not anything that's going to burn, is it?
Why?
Well, because as I was driving up here, I saw this clown.
Clown?
Yeah, and he had this beautiful dog, but it wasn't his.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I thought you might like to know about it.
Trouble?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
No, he's been following me all day.
Here, aren't you a pretty boy? And you don't know where he comes from?
No, I have no idea.
Oh, that's too bad. Come here. Hey, look. Look here. Well, we'll take care of him, okay?
Well.
Yeah, we'll see that everything's taken care of.
All right,
yeah,
then.
Yeah, okay. We'll get him in the car. Now, you stay.